Hello, and welcome to Horror and Monster Collectibles, where today we're going to be taking a look at this 18th scale exquisite mini Alien Covenant egg set from Hiya Toys. So let's go ahead and spin around and take a closer look. Alright guys, so in the packaging you'll find two each of three different egg designs and three different face hugger designs. Start with the eggs first. Now this closed egg is about 2¼ inches tall. Again, this is in 18th scale. And I waited a long time for these to ship. I don't know if BBTS was just taking their time or there was delays from Hiya, but it just took them a long time. I think I had this on order for about a year or a year and a half. It was a while. But this is the first Hiya Toys I've reviewed and opened up. I typically get them, but I leave them in the packaging. And I have a whole bunch of their Predator line. They're typically known for their Predator figures. They also have some Xenos coming out. There may be some already out, but I have a couple on order to go with this set. But I like the gloss on here. I like the paint app. And again, this is relatively cheap. I think this is more on the expensive side of their stuff. I think this was like $25 or maybe 30 for the set. Typically, their figures are, I think, about $20. But they're highly detailed for as small as they are. Now, this is the open sculpt with a hollow egg. But they actually have some pretty good colorization here, where it's a darker pink on the outside and it gets to lighter pink on the inside of the flaps. And they have pretty good detailing around the base, although it is just one shade. I really feel like they could have brought out the sculpt a little bit more with some added coloring on here. And then we will look at the opened but yet released face hugger. Again, I think overall, like, these look really cool. And the good thing about 18 scale stuff, while it's small, you can do really cool dioramas and they don't take up a whole lot of space. I do really like their Pred line, but I can't speak to the durability of the figures. I know that they have lots of articulation and lots of detailing and accessories at that scale. But again, I have not opened one up or watched a review on there. I really like the gloss coating on here too. Let's jump over to the first face hugger. And these are made from it feels almost like a rubber. It's a very, very soft durometer PVC or a rubber, and it's so small. You can see how big my fingers are compared to the detailing on here. But I actually like the coloring that they have in there for the mouth, but the face hugger itself is just monotone. Any of this stuff that you're seeing here is just shadowing from my studio lighting. In real life, this is all just one coloring, and they're kind of relying on shadows to give it depth. I do wish it had some different shading on here, but again, it's pretty soft. And I think with this tail, you might be able to, like, if you had a figure, you might be able to kind of wrap this guy around here like that and have it around the neck of the figure, which might look pretty cool, but you can't control these arms, which kind of sucks. But it would look cool in the egg if you just kind of prop them up in there, like so. Have them kind of leaping out, or maybe you can just kind of set them on there like that. This guy is basically the same sculpt, but the tail is a little bit more coiled up. And maybe this one we can do around the neck too, I'm not sure. But again, it doesn't really help because you don't have control of these fingers. Though I do like how they're raised up. So it still would look cool, like just sitting down, like on a surface. And then we have this guy, which is flattened out. And he looks kind of weird, just because he is so flat. But again, you know, these guys you can just kind of set in there like so. Make them look like they're springing out of there. Maybe you can just set them in there like that, though that looks weird. I really wish they had a way of just doing like a dynamic deal where he's kind of like leaping out of there like that, and he doesn't have to like rest on the egg. Unfortunately, he does. You'd have to probably spend some time playing around with that to get it to look right on a display. All right, guys, so that's about all there is to go over on this piece. I would like to say also that they add a cool little cardstock in the packaging that you can kind of use as a display background, which I think is a nice inclusion. And I just love the artwork on that too, which I think is from the movie, but it still looks rad. Overall, I'd say that they're a pretty good bang for your buck, and I think they would fit in good with a awesome Xeno display. Even if you had like a, you could even kind of fudge the movie timeline and stuff like that and do it with like a Pred Alien mix. As always, feel free to leave any questions or comments that you have on this, and I'll be happy to answer them. And also feel free to like and subscribe and click the bell for notifications for new videos. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.